Good evening. Can y'all hear me? Can y'all hear me on this microphone? Okay. This is a new song. You don't have to sing along because it's super duper new. Our Father, that which art in heaven, we will keep your holy name. Your kingdom as it is in heaven, let it be on earth the same. Give us our daily bread. You deliver us again forever and amen. Forever and amen. Forever and amen. Our Father, that which art in heaven, we will keep your holy name. Your kingdom as it is in heaven, let it be on earth the same. Give us our daily bread, forgive us every debt. Would you deliver us again, forever and amen. Forever and amen. Forever and amen. That's just a little taste of a song called Forever and Amen by Carrie Joby and Cody Carnes. That's not even, it might not even be out on the radio yet. The only thing that exists is a 9-minute version. It's too big. So we're going to work on that a little bit later in the year or maybe even next year. Again, that's called Forever and Amen. And thanks to Randy Nelson, we found a fresh arrangement of the Lord's Prayer, if you recognize what those words were. Our Father, that which art in heaven, we will keep your holy name, et cetera, et cetera. So that's just a little taste of what's coming up later. Okie dokie, guys, thank you so much for being here. This is our traditional hymn sing, and this is how we're opening tonight. We're going to get to some more modern hymns in a little while. But I want to start with number 100. We are going to crack open the hymnals. You do not have to stand for this portion at all. If your spirit is led to stand, to lift your hands, to clap your hands, to dance, you go right ahead. But right now, please feel free and comfortable to sit. We're going to start with hymn number 100. This is Thou Art Worthy. Doris Jones, are you in the auditorium? Yeah. Doris Jones. I'm going to ask for some assistance from Doris. Doris is going to come sing with me. Steve, I've got Doris on the orange wireless microphone right over here. And do you want to just read over my shoulder? Okay. All right, cool. All right. 100, Thou Art Worthy. Sing out if you know this. Oh. number 118. That's 118. This is, his name is Wonderful. Number 327. 327. This is a really beautiful song. It has a lot of detailed imagery in it, and it just takes you to a place where God's sacrifice for us feels real. This has four verses. Let's sing the Baptist verses. We're going to do 1, 2, and 4. For hymn number 327, this is the Old Rugged Cross.
On a thank you.
are singing parts out there. That's gorgeous. Let's flip on over to 329, just one page away. There is power in the blood. We're going to pick up the pace a little bit here. Let's do 1, 2, and 4 as well. And then we're actually going to... Oh, you're going to... Wow, that was so exciting. Okay.
Would you be free from your burden of sin? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you or evil a victory win? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Verse 2, would you be free?
Would you be free from your passion and pride? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Come for a cleansing to Calvary's tide. There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Would you do service?
Would you do service for Jesus your King? There's power in the blood, would you lift daily his praises to sing? There's wonderful power in the blood, there is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
Have you been to Jesus for the cleansing power? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb?
Are you fully trusting in his grace? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you washed in the blood, in the soul cleansing blood of the Lamb? Are you garments spotless, are they white as snow? Are you washed in the blood of the Lamb? Are you walking daily by the Savior's side? Are you washed in the blood?
Yeah, that's it. We're good. Everybody say thank you, Doris. Woo-hoo. Take it back up if you want to go up. I'd love for you guys to turn to 415. We got a couple more hymns, and then I am going to turn you loose on the hymnal. We're going to play Stump the Pianist. You can't. 415, this is We Are Called to Be God's People. I have used this hymn before in service. I've used it with a different tune, but we're going to use it with the tune in the hymnal today so you guys can kind of read those notes along. Like I said, I've used these words before because they are so, so strong. And whenever Frank talks about how we live in community with each other, this is one of the first hymns I go to and read because it's about servanthood. It's about reaching out to somebody else. And someone came up to me today and said, I was listening so hard to the words we sang today, and that is so meaningful. It's not just the music that teaches you something. Obviously, it's the lyrics that we gather together and sing together, and that's very powerful. I want you to notice these lyrics. We are called to be God's people, showing by our lives his grace, one in heart and one in spirit, sign of hope for all the race. Let us show how he has changed us and remade us as his own. Let us share our life together as we shall around his throne. The tune we're using today is... flat. All right. So here we are. You've probably heard this hymn tune before, even though it's an older one. So we're going to go ahead and sing all three verses. We are called to be God's people. So much for learning something that is a little bit unfamiliar. We're going to try to work that into the rotation of services because, like I said, I just think those words are very, very powerful about how we serve together and how we serve each other. I'm going to have you turn all the way over to 589. 589. This is called Here I Am, Lord. And this is actually kind of modern by traditional hymn standards. So if you don't know it, that's totally fine. Just listen to how the music flows and read the words along with us. And here is Here I Am, Lord.
Thank you.
am, Lord.
Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my arms.
Thank y'all for singing along, even if it's new and, well, new to you. Okay, call out your favorite number.
353.
353. Somebody tell me the name if you get to it.
Big Cranberry.
Yes. What key is this in? This is F. I'm trying to look and see how high it goes. Okay, we're good.
Heard about
358. Just a few pages over. Let's do one and two, and then let's jump over to five, because five is so good.
Sound that saved a wretch.
Cool. Here we go. When the conflict here is ended. When the conflict here is ended, and the race of man is won, he will say, if we are faithful, now the war, I shall well done. Let us when God is in it, with the God I heard 779 next. Is that correct? Oh, okay. Let's do. How are you doing on time? We're doing good. Let's do verse 1 and then verse 3. I love that key.
Oh,
508. Is that what I heard? 508. Oh, cool. All right, we're gonna do one and three. Probably come up with about three different hymn numbers that you would want to sing, and I am game to do it, so let's hang out and do that again. We are going to shift gears a little bit and hop up on whoever my team is. I'm going to head for a water bottle, and then we're going to get going on some songs.
I have your arm, Mike.
Here it is.
Can you click that in?
Howdy doody, everybody. We're gonna start with a song called Come As You Are. And a lot of you know this, so please, please, please feel free to sing along. I'm gonna tell you a little bit about David Crowder, because he wrote this song when he was young, and he would go to the revivalist meetings. Like, most of us remember what those were like. And when David Crowder would go to those, there would be this feeling in his soul, in his chest, in his heart, of what was going on when the revivalist called for an altar call at the end and everyone was singing, "Just As I Am." So when he wanted to write a song that came out of his own art and his own heart, this song came to him called Come As You Are. He wanted it to mean, you can't run too far from God. You can't have done too much to separate you from God. His grace is so extensive. And so the song Come As You Are was born out of that feeling. Matthew 11, verses 28 through 30 say, "Come to me, all who labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me. For I am gentle and lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy and my burden is light."
Thank you.
I would like to introduce our intrepid band members.
Before we sing the next song,
y'all know me, I'm Shelly.
Y'all know Courtney, she's here. Y'all know Randy Nelson, he's playing guitar and singing. Several of you already know Jared, our friend. He has generously come in to play and help out this evening. And this is his daughter, Caitlin. They have a church home, but we asked them if they could come help us out, and they have been so, so generous and so kind with their gifts and their talents. So we are super excited. It is such a special treat to have them playing and singing with us today. So thank you all. Isaiah chapter 61, verse 3 says, to grant to those who mourn in Zion, to give them a beautiful headdress instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning, the garment of praise instead of a faint spirit, that they may be called oaks of righteousness, the planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. This kind of substitution, a headdress instead of ashes, the oil of gladness instead of mourning. This kind of substitution is the thing that God does. There is a story in 2 Kings. It's Elisha's funeral. Elisha, the prophet in the Old Testament, is his funeral. His bones are in the ground. And I'm going to read you that little story. It's a tiny little story in 2 Kings chapter 13. And that story is where this next song is born out of. Elisha died and was buried. Now, Moabite raiders used to enter the country every spring. Once, while some Israelites were burying a man, suddenly they saw a band of raiders, so they threw the man's body into Elisha's tomb. When the body touched Elisha's bones, the man came to life and stood up on his feet. This is Graves into Gardens.
Treasures that fade are never enough.
Together. This is called No One Beside. It's written by Stephen Furtick, Chris Brown, and Tiffany Hammer. It says, within my heart, there is a melody that was not taught. In the darkest night, it still goes on, the anthem of my God. Psalm 28, verse 7 says, praise be to the Lord, for he has heard my cry for mercy. The Lord is my strength and my shield. My heart trusts in him, and he helps me. My heart leaps for joy, and with my song I praise him. The Lord is the strength of his people, a fortress of salvation for his anointed one. Save your people and bless your inheritance. Be their shepherd and carry them forever. sure some of you recognize also some of the words from the Magnificat. Oh, magnify the Lord. Let us exalt his name together. That was Mary's prayer when she found out what her role was in the life of Jesus. Let's do the next song. Living Hope. Oh, this is so exciting to me. Y'all already know In Christ Alone, a modern hymn. We love to sing it. Y'all are getting to know King of Kings, a modern hymn. We love to sing it. This is a new modern hymn called Living Hope. And what I love about these big anthems is that they tell the whole story from before creation all the way through the narrative of Christ's redemption for us. And Living Hope does just that. It starts at the beginning and goes all the way through. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 3. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. According to his great mercy, he has caused us to be born again to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you.
Yeah.
there. Our last song of the night is called My Jesus, and this is by a newcomer on the scene, Ann Wilson. She has a beautiful spirit and a beautiful story. I encourage you to look her up and find out how God called her to the ministry of music. Isaiah 43:19 says, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. No, that's from 1 Peter. Sorry. That's not what that says. Okay, I'm not going to read you the passage from Isaiah because I didn't write it down. I am going to read you the passage from John chapter 14, verse 6. And this has a lot to do with what the song My Jesus says. It's a little bit similar to Come As You Are in that if someone feels like there's a wall separating them from Jesus, there's not. John 14:6 says, Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
Are you past the point of weary? Is your burden weighing heavy? Is it all too much to carry? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Do you feel that empty feeling? 'Cause shame's done all its stealing, and you're desperate for some healing. Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way, rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you. Tears from broken dreams and wasted years and tell the past to disappear. Oh, let me tell you about my Jesus and all the wrong turns that you would go and undo if you could. Who can work it all for your good? Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. And let my Jesus change your life. Hallelujah. Cross to Calvary, pay the price for all my guilty. Who would care that much about me? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Oh, he makes a way where there ain't no way, rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can't save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. And let my Jesus change your life.
guys again for being here. That wraps up our evening. Thank you, Courtney, Jared, Randy, and Caitlin for being up here and for serving so faithfully and so graciously. And thank you, all of you, because what you do when you gather in to worship is you just lift up the Lord's name, and we all get to do that together, and that is a precious gift. Thank you so much for being here tonight. God bless you all. Mwah. Have a good week.